If I didn't plan, I would not get anything done in my life. I'd be a big hot mess. I swear, a little bit of prep goes a long way. Nothing motivates me more than a cup of coffee. I am hugely motivated by to-do lists. Pretty pathetic. So I wrote myself my to-do list of things that I need to get done today. I have about 80 million things. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I just got done getting ready for the day. Today's video is going to be all about like things that I do to set myself up to be productive throughout the week, to hit my health and wellness goals, and to just like stay on track with everything that I really want to accomplish for the week. Sorry, the lighting is like changing. I have you propped up against the window and that's only natural. I did wake up early, make sure that I got a good workout in. I got it done and out of the way before work this morning. I just find that when I do that, it helps my days flow so much smoother, not only because I have more energy, but because I don't have to stop midday to get a workout in, whether that's a quick lunch break workout or a workout after work. It's just so much more convenient to have it done and out of the way. So since I was able to get my workout in bright and early this morning, I kind of wanted to share like a little bit of tips on what I do to make sure that I can do that, and also kind of maybe give you guys a little bit of encouragement if you are looking to really like get in those morning workouts, because trust me, I know it's hard. I actually just filmed a morning routine, and in that morning routine I talked about how I feel like it should be illegal to wake up when it's pitch black outside. It is just like so hard. It is the last thing that you want to do, especially to wake up and get a workout in, but it's worth it. And if you can get yourself onto that habit and onto that routine, it just really makes the biggest changes. I almost feel like at first you have to like set yourself up with those little tips and just do it because you know you're gonna feel better. But then once you get into the routine, you will just kind of want to do it naturally and it will become second nature to you because you feel so good. So the first thing that I do, and I swear by every single night, is I lay out my workout clothes. So I used to lay them out like in my bedroom on this little ottoman. I would pick out 5 workout outfits for the week and lay them all out so they were good, ready to go. I haven't been doing that lately. Instead, I have been taking my workout outfit, just one, the night before and laying it in my bathroom so that it's right there. Like the second that I get up and use the bathroom, it's right there haunting me and I have to change into it. Having like everything prepared, laid out, ready to go, that helps so, so much. Just eliminates the excuses. You don't have to think as much because it's there, ready to go. You just grab and go change. So whether you are gonna be working out from home, going to a gym, if you are gonna be going to a gym, pack your gym bag, pack everything that you need to just make your morning run seamlessly. I swear setting yourself up for success like that makes a huge difference. Like some people even go as far as like having their coffee pot programmed in the morning so that it's already flowing and going by the time that you wake up. Nothing motivates me more than a cup of coffee, so that smell would definitely work. Prepping the night before, laying out your workout clothes, packing your lunch, whatever it may be, having everything ready to go, that's my first tip. My second tip is if you don't like coffee or if you're gonna take some sort of pre-workout supplement or something like that, I have these little pixie sticks, and sometimes I will even go as far as putting them under my pillow or on my nightstand. That way when my alarm goes off in the morning, I can just take it and within 10 minutes I'm like awake, energized, and then I'm ready to get my workout in. So that really helps me so much, and I know that that's almost like pretty pathetic that I need it like under my pillow, but I'm telling you, with the season change, fall time, it's so much harder to want to get out of your warm cozy bed when it's dark outside. So it really does help, and you gotta do what you gotta do. So if that's gonna help you, I definitely recommend it. I always really try to remind myself that I never regret getting out of bed to work out, but I always regret sleeping in. in missing my workout because I'm always like, gosh, Monique, why don't you just get that done in the morning? It's really not that hard. It makes your days go by so much smoother. You have happier, more positive days. You feel better. Like, just do it. And honestly, I feel like it is such a mental thing, and it is such a mental thing because the second that I'm up and I start walking around, I'm fine, and it's really not that hard to get the workout in or to just wake up early to be productive. When I lay there in bed thinking about it, I feel like it's like hiking Mount Everest. It feels like just the most challenging thing to do in the whole entire world. I don't know why our brains think like that, but really, if you just don't think about it, don't build it up in your head, it really isn't that big of a deal, and you'll be so happy and thankful that you got up. Those are just like a few of my little tips. I could definitely give a lot more, but I feel like I would have to have like a dedicated video on that. So if you want to hear more tips on like how to become a morning person or how to work out bright and early in the morning, then leave a comment down below and let me know. Also, give this video a thumbs up. That helps let me know too. But that's all that I'm gonna share for that today. Like I said, I work from home, so I need to get going and get started on my work day and be productive on that end. And then I can get productive in my personal life. Okay, guys, I have been working for a while now and I'm about to take my lunch break. Typically, you do not take long lunch breaks working from home. 30 minutes top. So I wrote myself my to-do list of things that I need to get done today. I have about 80 million things. I'm just gonna like take you along with me and we're gonna knock it all out together. And hopefully this gives you a little bit of like inspiration tackling your own to-do list or how to get things accomplished throughout the week. So one of the things that I have on here is laundry. Maybe this will come with age, but I am not somebody that is very consistent with my laundry. I don't have a laundry routine or anything. Like it's not every Sunday I do my laundry. I just do it when I have time. And normally I kind of get on a binge because I have so much to do. So don't come to me for laundry tips. But typically when I do my laundry, I do like 3 or so loads just because I'm a binge laundry washer. This is everything that I have to wash. About 2 heaping baskets. So I'm going to kind of sort through this and get going on it. Okay, I got the laundry going, and the next thing that I'm going to do just real quick on my lunch break is take care of all this mess from when I organized my closet a couple weeks ago. I can't believe I'm even admitting that I still haven't taken care of it, but I have just been a really busy gal, and you know, no excuses, but I'm going to knock it off my to-do list now and get it done because it has been here for way too long. So this is kind of what I'm referring to. If you watched that vlog, then you know. It's really just stuff that needs to be donated besides my laptop and just kind of organized somewhere else. So I'm gonna real quick do this. It should not take me long at all because it's already kind of organized even though it doesn't look like it. And that will be a huge thing checked off of my to-do list for the day. Like a cargo, you will carry me. I just hope you know my depth. Even though it makes no sense. Sometimes I'm broken. Okay, I real quick organized my books. I don't really have that many books because I read a lot on my Kindle app. But these aren't really like organized by any means. I just stacked them up on the shelf. That's another big accomplishment because they had just been sitting on the floor for way too long and it just looks so much better even with them not being organized but just put away. I am hugely motivated by to-do lists and honestly, nothing feels better than crossing things off. So that is what I'm doing right now. Doesn't look like I really have a lot to cross off since it's early in the day. But anyway, now I'm going to get back to work with my little buddy, Romy. Hi. Hey, baby. Okay, I am done with work for the day, which means I can get back on to crossing things off my to-do list. Seriously, have so much to do. So something that I always like to do when I have a lot to get done and not a lot of time, like right now, for example, because I need to go run an errand in about 30 minutes, is I like to set a timer. So I'm going to set a timer on my phone for 30 minutes because that's all I have. And I'm going to try to get as much knocked off of my to-do list that I can. I don't know what it is about setting timers, but I swear it just like motivates me to make it a fun little competition or like game. And I'm just able to like go super speed mode and just get things done. So the first thing that I really want to do is tidy up my office. Office can get pretty messy pretty quickly, so I'm going to do that so that I can have it clean and ready to go for the rest of the week. So let's go, let's get the party started. And I don't know if we should really call it a party, but let's get to knocking things off of my to-do list. Setting my timer. Okay, I got 14 minutes left, and my office, I'm gonna flip this around to show you. Office is all clean with the exception of that box right there. I need to bring it downstairs or put it somewhere in storage, but it is all clean. So you guys know that blanket on the floor, I cannot pick it up because it's for my cat, but I do need to pick it up because this floor could use a vacuum. But I got everything wiped off, looking good, organized, and it just feels good to have it all done and looking good for the week. The next thing that I'm going to do on my to-do list while I have time is lay out my workout clothes in the bathroom so that they're ready to go for tomorrow morning. I'm telling you guys, setting yourself up for success makes a big difference. And then I think I'm going to sit down, plan the rest of my week, schedule in my workouts, and do everything that I can do to make sure the rest of my week flows smoothly. I always tell myself, if you fail to plan, then you are planning to fail. Is that the phrase? I don't know, but you guys know what I mean because I'm a big planner. If I didn't plan, I would not get anything done in my life. I'd be a big hot mess. So I kind of like to look at my week if I'm working from home, that see if I'm working from home that day, see if I have anything that I need to do that night, just to kind of know like what time of the day I need to aim to get my workout in. So I, like I said, have been back on track of waking up in the morning and getting in my workout. So I try to like not even give myself a backup plan. I think it just helps so much to like write down everything that you have to do, and then you can kind of pencil it in like, okay, I have time for a workout from 10 to 11, or I have time for a workout right after work at 5, or pencil it in like an appointment that you will not miss. And that helps to ensure that you are getting your workouts in. My timer went off, oh no. Anyway, just real quick before I have to leave, but that helps to ensure that you are staying on track with your workouts and making sure that you are getting them in. It doesn't have to be a long, hour-long whole escapade. Really, if you only have time for a 20-minute workout, do it. People always underestimate those quick workouts, but I swear, sometimes the quick ones are my better workouts because I'm so much more focused and have my head in the game. But anyway, just getting off track on a tangent. That's how I like to schedule in my workouts. I typically try to do that every week at the start of the week. And then I need to mention the night before, I will create, I'm gonna show you real quick an example, but I will create like a little schedule like this where I'm time blocking to make sure that I get everything from up here down into this section and accounted for. Sometimes you look at your to-do list and you're just like, oh my gosh, this is so overwhelming. I am never going to get all this done. But then when you create a schedule like this and people think that I'm like crazy, but it actually makes things so much easier and makes you less stressed because you have a plan. And you know, it might not always go according to the plan, but you still have it to fall back on. And you know what? I can accomplish everything on my to-do list. It's really not as overwhelming as I've built it up to be in my brain. But anyway, now I can cross off scheduling my workouts and planning for the week on my to-do list. So it looks like the rest of the things I have to do tonight is respond to comments, go for a walk, which I'm going to do in a little bit. Dancing with the Stars is on. I know I'm crazy. I had to pencil that in. Clean my cat's litter box and order moisturizer, which I did do that. It's all out. I don't think that you want to watch me clean my cat. Oh my gosh, I cannot talk today. But I do not think that you guys want to watch me clean my cat's litter box. I don't blame you. But other than that, I think I did pretty good on getting things crossed off my to-do list. It always feels so, so good to be productive. And I swear, a little bit of prep goes a long way and makes your weeks go so, so much smoother. So if you are not a planner in any way, I highly recommend just taking like one little tip from this video, whether it's laying out your workout clothes the night before or just simply creating a to-do list. I swear you'll become so much more motivated and your life will just flow so much more smoothly. I'm going to go run my errand now that I needed to run 10 minutes ago.